وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
إن شاء الله I want to invite you to embark on a journey of memorizing the Quran in its entirety within 2 to 3 years. It doesn't matter what level you're at. If you can't read, we have a program which will inshallah get you to be fluent in the Quran. Inshallah, we want within 2 years the whole masjid inshallah to be full of Hufadh al-Quran.
Ya sa'ili an madhhabi wa aqidati رزق الهدى من للهداية يسأل اسمع كلام محقق في قولي
إنه ليسير على من يسره الله. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us, indeed it is easy, a matter becomes easy upon whomsoever Allah makes it easy. So inshallah, if Allah makes it easy for them and they are sincere, then Allah will make it easy for them to tread on that path. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. So if they come with their sincerity, they come with their motivation, their drive, likewise they come with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they manifest what they're learning into themselves, then inshallah they'll do so. And today was a motivation for them. I believe it's definitely a motivation for them to do so.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Amir, Ahmed, Yusuf, Abdurrahman, شافعي هيا شافعي كم لا ينتني عنه ولا
يتبدل
لا ان شاء الله
فلا تظلم نفس شيئا وان كان مثقال حبه من خردل فتكن
وان كان مثقال حبه من خردل اتينا بها
وإن كان مثقال حبة من خردل أتينا بها
وإن كان مثقال حبة وإن كان مثقال حبة
وإن كان مثقال حبة من خردل أتينا بها وكفى بنا حاسبين.
إن كتاب الله أوثق شافع وأغنى غناء واهبا متفضيلا وخير جليس لا يمل حديثه وتردده يزداد فيه تجملا.
أي عبد الرحمن Stop. When you read, make sure the ending of the verse, Basir, Nadir, you have a choice of two. The main thing, the way you should do it is stretch it. If you're going to not stretch them, you can't stretch all of them. And you have to be consistent with the recitation. So make sure, inshallah, you just correct the ending of each verse. Other than that, that was fine, inshallah. And try to read a bit slower, like, you know, otherwise it's good, inshallah.
I started my journey of memorizing the Quran about 2 years ago.
Inshallah, I plan to finish the Quran, inshallah, sometime next year, inshallah. Hopefully soon.
إذ أرسلنا إليهم اثنين فكذبوهما فعززنا بثالث فقالوا إنا إليكم مرسلون فقالوا إنا إليكم مرسلون
أولا تبارك رحمن الرحيم وموئلا وثنيت صلى الله ربي.
Again, another advice what our teacher gave us, it's important that you have a teacher. Alhamdulillah, we have a teacher. It's important that you have a structure. So someone telling you or showing you the way, a structured sort of plan that you do each day.
الحمد لله دائما وما ليس مبدوءا به أجدم العالى وبعد فحبل الله فينا كتابه فجاهد به حبل العدا متحبيلا.
هيا عامر إن شاء الله come your turn. Ayed, is this your mushaf? Does it look like your normal one, is it? Huh? You know what that means, right? Why did you forget?
Literally left late.
You know the rule is, if you don't bring your own mushaf, you don't get to read. Also, you know that bringing your mushaf is important. Why is it important?
So that follow the same mushaf.
I know, but if you keep bringing your own one, why is that a bad thing?
It's not good for consistency.
It's not good for?
Consistency.
Consistency, what else though? More importantly?
Being disciplined. Mistakes.
Mistakes. How are you going to know your mistakes if you keep getting a new mushaf every week? So inshallah, as you know the rule already, and you live local, go home inshallah, you're not going to read.
What would you say to those people as well that think that they're too old or too busy to start memorizing the Quran?
So too old, number one, the overwhelming majority of the companions that memorized the Quran, they were old. These people that we hear of, the Mufassirun, etc., they were old in age. A journey which began 2 years ago. A group of brothers who began their journey of memorizing the Quran. The speech of Allah, the creator of the heavens and the earth. Today is a special day. Two brothers who grew up in the same household, started their journey at the same time, started at the same place, with the same teacher. Today, we witness them both complete the memorization of the Quran together, just as they started.
So what made me start memorizing the Quran, I remember in 2017, before I joined the class with Ustad Abdul Ahad, I was in Taraweeh with my brother and the masjid near our house, so they were praying Qiyam al-Layl, and so they tend to like let little kids lead during Qiyam al-Layl. So I was like, a little kid was leading and Allahumma barik, he was like reciting very, very well. So I was very motivated by that, and I said to Mukhtar, you know, I would love to memorize the Quran. Then from there, I started. I never looked back.
لما فصل طالوت بالجنود قال إن الله مبتليكم بنهر فمن شرب منه فليس مني ومن لم يطعمه فإنه مني إلا من اغترف غرفة بيده فشربوا منه إلا قليلا منهم.
Yeah, for me personally, it was the beginning of seeking knowledge, because we obviously know that you have to start with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I said to myself, let me focus on that, and that was the beginning of knowledge for me personally, you know, focusing on the Quran.
فلما جاوزه هو والذين آمنوا معه قالوا لا طاقة لنا اليوم بجالوت وجنوده قال الذين يظنون أنهم ملاقوا الله كم من فئة قليلة غلبت فئة كثيرة بإذن الله والله مع الصابرين.
How did you guys manage to stay at the same level throughout the whole thing? Were you guys competing or something, not trying to let the other guy get ahead? What was the reason?
So subhanAllah, when we first started, I think we started at the same juz, Qad Sami'a. And then I was beating him for a little while. And then basically he caught up and they started beating me. So it was always like a neck and neck race, you know? Yeah, that's the thing that kept us going, to be honest.
So we had like a little competition, you know, who could memorize the Quran first. So, you know, maybe 1 month I'd be ahead of him, the next month he'd catch up to me. But, that's it really.
فضائل لكن ما الصديق منهم أفضل وأقول
وأشهدوا إذا تبايعتم ولا يضار كاتب ولا شهيد وإن تفعلوا فإنه فسوق بكم واتقوا الله ويعلمكم الله والله بكل شيء عليم وإن كنتم على سفر ولم تجدوا كاتبا فرهان مقبوضة فإن أمن بعضكم بعضا فليؤدي الذي اؤتمن أمانته وليتق الله ربه ولا تكتموا الشهادة ومن يكتمها فإنه آثم قلبه والله بما تعملون عليم لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين
آمين يا رب أيها القارئ به متمسكا مجلا له في كل حال مبجلا هنيئا مريئا والدا
It took hours of dedication, hard work, perseverance, patience, sacrifice, early mornings, late nights, But here they are today, the day it all pays off. A proud teacher who has been honored to transmit the words of Allah to another servant of his and continue the legacy of transmission. I ask Allah to bless them both, allow them to attain the understanding of his speech and likewise to act upon that which they carry in their hearts so that the Quran is an evidence for them not one which is against them. 13 students continue their journey, and my hopes for them are bright, that they shall tread on the same path as our two brothers, with the help of Allah, and similar hard work, dedication, and perseverance, they shall attain such lofty status with the permission of Allah.
MashaAllah, Allahumma barik. You guys both managed to finish the Quran today at the same time. First question is, how did you guys do it?
Bismillah wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah. Rabbi shahli sadri wa yassirli amri. Wa ahlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Alhamdulillah, I managed to begin this journey 2.5 years ago in February of 2018.
I also started this journey in February of 2018.
And how did you guys feel that you both finished today on the same day? You started on the same day. So how did you guys feel about it?
Yes, alhamdulillah, it's a feeling of happiness coupled with a feeling of, you know, responsibility. Because the Quran could be a witness for you or against you. So whilst I'm happy, it's a bit of, you know, you have to be serious and try to act upon the Quran and continue to do muraja'ah.
I'm very happy and I thank Allah and I ask Allah to make us of a people who act upon the Quran. Alhamdulillah, couldn't be more
happy. So you said it was the start of Sikh knowledge, yeah. But you at the same time was at university whilst you started memorizing the Quran.
Mm-hmm.
So how did you manage to balance between memorizing the Quran and staying in university like a lot of youngsters are nowadays?
Yeah, SubhanAllah, it was very tough. And you know, don't get me wrong, there were days where it was very good and days where it wasn't so good. But for me, it was about, you know, your high shouldn't be too high and your low shouldn't be too low. Always be grateful for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, وَإِذْ تَأَذَنَ رَبَّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَمَا بِكُمْ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. So whenever you memorize something, be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He will increase you. So that's what I did.
Manad, what was your sort of method that you used to use to
memorize? So my method was, actually I just want to say, initially when I started memorizing the Quran, I actually didn't memorize the way I do it now. So I started by memorizing half a page of the Quran, and the time it would take me to memorize was very long. I remember one day in Ramadan where it took me about 45 minutes or so to memorize Surah At-Tariq, and you know, after that, I forgot it immediately.
Mm.
So that's just a little side story. So my method of memorizing the Quran, I would start off with a verse on the top of the page. I would repeat that verse. I wouldn't say like 10 or 20 times. It depended on how much time it needed for it to be stuck into my brain. And then after that, I would move on to the next verse, and then I'll connect the two verses, and I'll do that for every single verse. And then I'll recite the whole page again from top to bottom. حَقَّ
رَبَّهُمْ وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ بِغَيْرٍ كَيْفٍ يَنْزِلُ. Lastly, we'd like to welcome our teacher, Ustaz Bilahad, who's walked the two brothers Mukhtar and Muhannad through their journey. How do you feel today that two of your students finished the Quran?
بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. First of all, I would like to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and show my gratitude to He, Rabbul Izzah, that He has given me the ability and the chance and the opportunity to pass on the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The speech that He spoke, a speaking that befits His Majesty, a real speaking. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put on my scale of good deeds and likewise to accept it from me. Because it's an honor for me to be able to do it, and Allah only gives the opportunity to some people. Let alone memorizing the Quran in itself is an honor, but being able to now pass it on to someone else and leave a legacy with them for myself, that when I pass away, I get the rewards of every little thing that they recite, every harf, every harakah that they recite, inshaAllah ta'ala will be on my scale of good deeds. Likewise, anybody they teach. Secondly, I'm very happy for them, specifically watching them in their journey. These two brothers, they really worked hard. So I'm happy, of course, for myself, but likewise happy for them because they really, really deserve to be carrying the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their hearts. Likewise, I feel like I have a burden on myself now. Likewise, they have a burden on themselves from the angle that now they need to begin, not just begin, but they need to, until they meet Allah, act upon this Quran so that the Quran is not a intercessor against them or a, shall I say, an evidence against them, but rather evidence for them. And as our pious predecessors used to say, shame on the man who recites the Quran and the Quran is cursing him. And he reads, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا, and this person gets close to zina. He reads verses where Allah says, وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا, don't walk on the earth in an arrogant manner, and they walk on the earth in an arrogant manner. وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍ, don't say uff to your parents, but they say it. So this burden and this feeling, some sort of anxiety feels, is in me, shall I say, because it's definitely a burden that is upon me and both of them as well. وَأُقِرُّ بِالْمِيزَانِ
وَالْحَوْضِ الَّذِي أَرْجُو بِأَنِّي مِنْ. So what were any obstacles you might have come across during your journey memorizing the Quran?
For me, it was definitely balancing uni with the Quran. So that required me, for example, to wake up early, to sleep late, to, you know, go out for my leisure time with my friends. It required a lot of sacrifice on that part.
And so sometimes during a journey, you might have felt like we all do in a specific journey when we're trying to do something, you become demotivated or you just plateau. Did you ever feel like that? Did you ever become demotivated? And how did you fight against that?
Yeah, definitely. I think it's very natural. What I personally did, I used to watch a lot of like Quran competitions, like the one in Dubai. There's one at Shal TV in North America as well. I used to watch those competitions and I used to see the kids and it used to motivate me. You know, that, mashallah, they're very young and some are like our ages. I used to look up to them and that's what kept me going.
Same question. I think it's very normal for you to feel demotivated during your journey in the memorization of the Quran. And I don't want people to think that it doesn't happen. It happens to all of us. So I actually had a period of time where I didn't come to the classes for 6 whole months. And not a lot of people know that, but it's true. And you know, you're gonna feel demotivated, but you know, never give up and always remember why you actually started. That's what helped me.
Right, so what would be your advice to those people that think they're too old to start memorizing or it's too late for them to start memorizing? What would your advice be to those people?
My advice would be it's never too late to memorize the Quran, no matter how old you are. I always used to think, I used to think that as well, to be honest. Like, I'm 20, 21 years old now, maybe my time's over, it's too late. But I think you can memorize the Quran at any given age. It's just, it's all about time management. How you manage your time and, you know, just go for it.
Those people that say they're too busy as well.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, you're never too busy for anything, you know. If you really want to do something, you're going to make time for it. That's what I'll say.
So, this question is both of you as well. Who would you say helped you the most during this journey of yours?
After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my parents. I want to thank my parents. I wouldn't have memorized the Quran without my parents and their support. Continuously supporting me and motivating me, you know, and encouraging me not to give up. So I want to thank my parents. Also, I have to thank my teacher. You know, he was very supportive during, you know, the dark times, if I would say. He'd always check up on me. And, you know, I would advise people to find a teacher, you know, who you can connect with, you know, not just on a, not just with the Quran, but you know, someone you can actually talk to, and you know, that's something I always thank him for, because you know, he checked on me quite a lot, and it wasn't just about the Quran, like, you know, it'd go quite personal as well. So I want to thank my teacher. So
yeah, I want to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost, obviously, and thereafter my teacher Sayyid Abdul Ahad hafidhahullah wa ra'ahu, and also my brother. I think he pushed me a lot. I think if it wasn't for him keeping me in check, I would have maybe, you know, not finished. So my brother as well.
Was there anything special about Mukhtar and Muhannad, these two students, that you can think of?
So Mukhtar and Muhannad, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, they were two brothers who are very, or they are two brothers who are very, very, very unique. And I don't know how to describe them, because they have something which, like, you just have to know them. They have some sort, they have an element inside them which I can't really describe. There was something about them that they naturally acted upon the Quran. They were generally quiet, they were very humble, they were very kind. They were people who were close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they would do ibadah that people don't know of. And the Quran really, really, really meant something to them. I'm not saying the other brothers, it doesn't mean something to them, but they, like, for them it was clearly evident. I remember a time where Mukhtar, he was reciting to me his normal portion of the Quran on a weekly basis. He'd read to me. And he was the first person who I actually witnessed to cry from the Quran, yani reading to me. And no one's ever read the Quran to me and began to cry. So Mukhtar, one day he was reciting قول الله تبارك وتعالى يومئذ يتبعون الداعية لا عوج له وخشعت الأصوات للرحمن فلا تسمع إلا همسا. And he stopped and he began to cry and cry and cry, and he couldn't continue reciting. I said, continue inshallah. And then we just stopped. Yani we could not finish the surah. And if we ponder upon the meaning of it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that there will be a speaker, a caller, that Allah is going to assign on the day of judgment. The job is for him to just call the people. But it's a voice. We don't know where the voice is going to come from. It's a voice somewhere. And this caller is going to call the people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mawqif al-mahshar, the mahshar, where the people are going to be gathered. You know, the plains of the Day of Judgment, where people are going to come naked, uncircumcised, where the sun will be right close to us, and everybody's going to come to Allah. Min Adam alayhi salam until the last person to be alive. And Allah said, يَوْمَ يَتَّبِعُونَ يَوْمَ إِذٍ يَتَّبِعُونَ الدَّاعِ. That day the people are going to follow that caller, any call he makes. He's going to say, everybody come here, and they'll follow him. They're not going to have a choice. لَا عِوَجَ لَهُ. There's no bent crookedness. Yani everybody's going to come and just, yani, ta'a. Everybody's scared. Nobody's going to think twice. There's no going left, right. Everybody's going to follow him. In a state of fear. وَخَشَعَتِ الْأَصْوَاتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ. And the people on that day, their voices and themselves, they're going to be in a state of humility and scaring. فَلَا تَسْمَعُ إِلَّا هَمْسًا. You're not going to hear anything. Yani, the little footsteps that we even hear, even this, because people are going to be scared. And Mukhtar, may Allah bless him, he began to cry and cry and cry. And I've never witnessed that before. To see someone his age, quite young, you know, in the UK, etc. It was something very, very amazing.
The brothers today, mashallah, finishing the Quran, it motivated me a lot. Not only by the fact that they finished it, but the way they did it in such beautiful voices. And you can see the understanding of the Quran as they read it, as they stop, and the tajweed as well with it. It's really motivational, and it's actually pushed me further to wanting to finish my goal of memorizing the Quran.
Seeing our classmates, mashallah, today finishing their memorization of the Quran is very, very motivating, mashallah. Especially me and my brother as well. We're both also brothers. So seeing them both do it, subhanAllah, it makes it a little bit more sort of realistic or relatable, inshallah.
What would your advice be to those who also say that they're too old or too busy or that they have to go abroad to memorize the Quran? What would your advice be to those people? What would you say to those people?
Firstly, I'll say to them that you're never too busy for anything, and anything you really want, and you'll get it and you'll make time for it. It's up to you to do that. And if you think that you're too old or you don't have time, it's not possible for you, then you need to look at some scholars of the past, not even scholars, you just look at people from our era. They've finished the Quran late ages, 50 plus. There's a lot of people out there you can look up to. As we've just seen today, two brothers, mashallah, they finished the Quran, memorized Hanan Barik. It's up to you.
To the person who might be deluded by the misconception that he cannot do it, or he doesn't have the time, or he's too old, wallahi, these are just little things that are just stopping you from beginning your journey, wallahi. Everyone has time. You have time for, you make time. Mm-hmm. And why would you not make time for the Quran, the speech of Allah? All it takes is as little as an hour or 2 hours a day. And to think, if someone cannot spare an hour, then it's a bit of a sad thing.
And lastly, you, what would you say to those people as well that think that they're too old or too busy to start memorizing the Quran?
So too old, number one, the overwhelming majority of the companions that memorized the Quran, they were old. These people that we hear of, the Mufassirun, etc., they were old in age. The Sahaba, the Kibar al-Sahaba, that's point number one. Point number two, if we look at our time now, there's examples of old people that memorize the Quran. You can find them online, etc. Thirdly, we have two examples today of two brothers that started in the UK. They're 22 and 23 years of age, and it's not necessarily a young age, and only people finish when they're 10, 12, etc. So it's not about age, it's about how much effort you put in. So if today was not an example, you probably are someone who was born in the UK. You're probably someone who grew up in the UK. You're probably someone who's struggling with the fitna in the UK likewise. You're probably someone in university and really busy. You're probably someone who's similar to their age, if not slightly older. And you fit their category exactly. Their description, you fit it perfectly. So if that's not an example, then I don't know what's an example. Secondly, pertaining to someone who's busy, the word busy is only subjective to that which you make yourself busy for. You wouldn't be too busy to have your breakfast. You wouldn't be too busy to not have your lunch. Likewise, too busy to have your dinner. You wouldn't go the whole day without eating. You wouldn't say, I was too busy. Like as you wouldn't say, I'm too busy to work. All it means is food and work and education, the things you're busying yourself now with are so important that you physically can't say, I'm too busy. So make the Quran likewise and seeking knowledge on that same level. That excuse won't exist.